McAvoy.
What has happened?
Your brother.
What's he done this time?
The newspapers are all over Twopenny's murder, and if that weren't enough, someone has stolen the currency printing plates. Was that also Jacob's doing?
I doubt it.
Now, no one trusts the bank or England's currency. There will be inflation, riots, manufacturing will jump to America for the cheap labor. In short, Britain is done for.
Jacob, you've really put your foot in it now. What if I smuggle the plates back into the bank?
Well, certainly help. Better yet, it would call into question the stories on Twopenny's murder, which would restore confidence in the economy.
That's settled then. Britain lives to see another day.
Oh, and if it's not too much trouble, would you mind destroying any counterfeit notes you come across so they don't circulate?
Of course.
It really is very good of you to help.
Exploitation! No more slave wages!
Follow me. The counterfeit money is being spent. With those printing plates, it's nearly impossible to tell the real notes from the fake ones.
Mr. Avalon.
If this gets out... Well, I've said this already. When people don't trust their currency, and we're already seeing riots...
Mr. Avalon.
I have the utmost faith in you, Miss Fry.
The counterfeiters.
anyone could be trying to get in.
Yes, sir.
Keep this place locked down.
Yes, sir.
Of course, now I have to find you a new birthday present.
Guard this place as you would the Bank of England itself.
Absolutely, sir.
If you don't stop, you'll regret it. Am I clear?
I do believe that is a cue to exit the
scene. Watch your step!
Now to sneak these back into the bank.
You're safe from me over there!
There you go. There, as if they were never taken.
Well, the London papers are running the story of how it was all a hoax. No more riots. Faith in the bank restored. Finally, I might get a quiet night on patrol. Miss Fry, I can't thank you enough.
Glad we've averted catastrophe, Sergeant. Although it's Jacob who should be thanking me.